Hey there, thanks for tuning in. Welcome back to the Torgo Entertainment YouTube channel. Torgo here. Welcome back to another gig log and welcome back to another wedding.
From the age of exploration, the neighbor of nations, Il Cartographer.
He making the map. He taking no crap.
I don't typically appear dressed up at this point of these videos. So again, full disclosure, this was filmed 2 weeks after the wedding in this video. I'm actually on my way to a wedding as a guest. I know, even on my days off, I still have to go do weddings. That's how it works sometimes. Part of the reason why yesterday's gig log ended up being so short is because I couldn't really film anything for it. Because this week has been absolutely ridiculous. The homecoming yesterday was the sixth straight day of DJ gigs that I've had. Today marks number 7, and I had to bolt right out the door from my day job in order to do this homecoming. So something had to give in order for me to have time to do everything. And filming stuff for this wedding and the homecoming yesterday ended up taking the fall on that one. Hi, Flight of the Conchords, how are you? But today, we celebrate the wedding of Josh and Kaylee. This is an all-star weddings wedding, the second to last one I have through them. And today's wedding, we head to Bear Mountain Inn and Spa. I don't remember the exact name of the town, Tompkins Cove, I think it is, but it's Bear Mountain State Park on the east side of the state. Let's go to the map and show you exactly where that is. Surprise, 3.5 hours away. Just like all the all-star weddings seem to be, which is part of the reason I'm not gonna be doing too much for them anymore. And because it's a brand new venue, I did have a chance to make my way out there much earlier in the year. I am able to visit these places in spurts, you know, get 2 or 3 done in a day, so it's not as taxing on, you know, mileage or whatnot. Regardless, let's go case the joint.
I thought you said the library was closed, Frank.
This is what they call casing.
Cocktail hour in this corner. But I could potentially also go in this corner in here. And the ceremony is right outside these doors. Ceremony takes place. I'm going to be set up along this wall. They would be coming from this direction where this gentleman is, around the side. The speaker's got to go down that way. And the load in. So the couple is going to be set right here, in front of this fireplace area. And the dance floor will be here-ish. I am way, way, way over here in this little nook. Power's available right here. This wall will be moved, but that's a huge distance. Guess we'll have to make it work. Maybe these are magnetic, so that might work. I'm hoping. Hope these don't be wood. It's all wood. Okay, we'll make that work. Hard to get visits in when there's a wedding going on where you are.
So there's a lot of different setups going on, and the room itself where the reception is quite long. I was a little bit hesitant about how that was going to work, especially because I was going to be off to the side. I know my speakers are loud enough where they can definitely do that, but you know, getting the microphone levels just right and those poor tables that are going to be in front of me are just going to be deafened by the time everything actually happens. What's interesting about this wedding is Josh and Kaylee are big WWE wrestling fans, so a lot of the songs that they're gonna have are wrestling themes. I am not a wrestling fan. I watched WWF when I was like, you know, 3 or 4. I think we had the plush Bret Hitman Hart toy, or maybe it was Ultimate Warrior, I don't remember which one, but these kinds of names tell you how long it's been since I've watched wrestling. Fortunately, Phil, who's coming with me today, is a huge wrestling fan, so he was actually very helpful with determining what songs out of the ones that they had said that they wanted apply to what wrestler. I think he had the idea to have a whole bunch of red Solo cups and spill them on people based on the theme that was played. Again, this is entirely Greek to me, I have no idea. So ceremony will be outdoors and the cocktail hour is in 2 adjacent rooms, and then the reception is in the hall upstairs. It's a lot to do, it's a lot to handle, but we've handled worse, we can definitely get through this. Not much to say about this one, I hope you're ready for a good time. Let's go! This is a rare instance where the overhead photo here is not going to tell you a dang thing because of how much the plans had to change over the course of the evening. Obviously, you saw the rain that we had on the drive up, and that ceremony is not happening outdoors anymore. And everything's kind of stacked because it's a multiple story building. So yeah, the reception's going to be here, cocktail is kind of below in the same location, so it doesn't tell you very much. So you're going to have to look at this footage to figure it out. Let's check out the setup. Yeah, they had the ceremony where the reception was. That meant the dance floor was in these pillars as well. And we have us set up right over to the side with the Danny Max Infinity XL board, console, box, I guess you could call it. The Bose F1812 tops and bottoms. We have the Allendale Defender there. We only needed the one up here. You'll see the other one later. We have everything inside the Danny Max that you've seen multiple times before, including the Roland DJ808 controller. We have the itinerary on the clipboard, but where's the tablet? You'll see that later as well. And here we have the Samsung Odyssey Z notebook running virtual DJ. And here we have the posts for the lights and a mic stand. The mic stand is for their vows. Obviously, we can't set up the lights right now because you don't need those lights during ceremony, so we just had it off to the side. The lights are packed away. You'll see those later during reception. The uplights are not ours, they paid a separate company for that, but they're just gonna stay solid orange the entire time. I've seen these lights before. When I did Eli and Meg's wedding 2 years ago, they used very similar uplights that didn't do very much, and I didn't feel like tapping into them to make them do fun things because, you know, not my equipment. Let's head downstairs and show you the cocktail area. So as I pointed out in the preview footage, right out these doors on the side of the building is where the ceremony was going to take place, but you can see how wet it is out, so they moved it all inside naturally. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. We decided to have the cocktail music in both rooms, which means I had to do a little bit of fidgeting with the cords. Here we have the RCF 708A speaker. We don't see this too often on this channel. And we have the power inverter from Yeti, the tablet that has all the music on it. And in the other room, you'll see the Bose S1 Pro. Now, the Bose S1 Pro has the Bluetooth capabilities from the tablet, but the RCF does not, and you can't really go line out easily on the Bose. It's one of the downsides of that speaker. So we have the Pro AV2 from Radial, and we're just gonna do a hard line mini to mini into the tablet, into the Radial, and then it'll do XLR outs to both of those speakers, and we'll be good to go. So that's the solution, and it worked out great. We only have time for one more thing, and you know what it is. It's time to level up. Let's go!
Oh, you don't want to talk while I'm doing this? I am doing the let's go. Let's go.
Husband and wife, please kiss. Let everyone see how much you love each other. And everyone have a good night. Everyone, it is my distinct pleasure to share with you the newly married couple, Josh and Paley.
Chapdelaine and Scott Nelson. Make some noise for your flower girl, Harper Nelson, everyone. Just like the movie. Next up, we have the parents of the bride, Dawn and Jeff Marinelli. I want you to keep that energy alive for the mother of the groom and her boyfriend, Cindy Quiroga and Joe Fischelli. And we're not done. Next up, make some noise for the stepmother of the groom and her special friend, Ella Marie Minduina and Peter Chapdelaine. It is time for me to introduce your wedding party. First up, give it up for Raya Hopkins, Michael Bass, and Brett Wisniewski. That's right, we got three more. Give it up for Bianca Venus, Jason Oliver, and Josh Golub. Jay Figueredo and Colin Brusha. Yeah. I don't know if the next pair is going to do this. I guess we'll find out. Kirsten McNew-Smith and Jake Gold. song very special to the two of them. This is by Martin Garrix featuring Khalid. It is called Ocean. And the dinner will be coming shortly. We're going to open up the dance floor for a little bit for anybody who wants to come out here to celebrate Josh, to celebrate Kaylee, to celebrate the time that we have together. We invite you to come on out here. This one's for Kaylee.
Entrees are rolling out at this time.
One more song.
You have me for 2 more hours, bro. We have Josh, we have Kaylee, we have 2 chairs. We need to have them lifted. Watch out for the lights. Up and to the left.
This one's a request from Josh. I know this just passed 2 days ago. But bear with it. Do you remember? Minutes left. You know what time it is.
Beautiful on the inside. You are innocent persona fine. And I will drag you down and sell you out. Run away. I am Judas in my
everybody for coming out. You guys have been wonderful to play for. But before we go, let's hear one more last huge round of applause for Josh and Kaylee. Give it up for your newlyweds one last time.
And I'm back the morning after. This is Woodside, New York. We got a hotel at the America's Best Value Inn. It is currently raining, as it has the entire weekend. That wedding was something else. It ended up going well. It's a truck. And we ended up saving it, but it was very annoying that on my itinerary, dinner was supposed to be at 7:50 and dinner dropped at 9:45? And then like dinner's gonna be at 9 o'clock. All right, fine, so it's gonna be late. So I had to have an open dance set after, you know, appetizers dropped. So that started at 8:30 with the parent dance, so I had to move that up. The dinner will drop at 9:00 and then 9 o'clock I was like, oh, we're delayed. Keep them going. And it's very hard to have that long of a time between appetizers and dinner. People are confused, they're like, what's going on? Why aren't we eating right now? But we ended up saving it a little bit. The photo booth helped out a lot. I'm happy those guys were there. They had a huge boon during that hour. And unfortunately, because once dinner dropped, you know, that's at least 45 minutes to an hour for dance floor at the end, which is the smallest I've had in a hot minute. So I'm sitting there quick mixing through all the stuff, you know. The groom is sitting there every minute or so, he's like, next song. So, you know, blasting through everything. I had to get like 50 songs for this wedding. Ended up not playing like any of them. That's how it goes sometimes. And then of course at the end, you know, being in this part of the state,
The roads were closed, so what was supposed to be a 10-minute drive between the venue and the hotel ended up being a 40-minute drive through the windiest, narrowest, darkest, wettest roads in upstate New York. And that was, you know, certainly an adventure, but we're here. I got a 3-hour drive plus to get home. Josh and Kaylee told me multiple times that we were the vendors that, you know, did the best and were on top of it and put the effort in, and they were very appreciative. So it always feels good to hear that even though I'm frustrated, they're having fun. A playlist will be at the tail end of this video. Thank you so much for tuning in. Torgo with Torgo Entertainment. A wedding in Corning, New York next weekend. So, you know, close to home. Very little driving footage, but some people won't mind that. But we will see you at the next event. Take care.